You know, I don't believe it. Plus, you'd know if your partner was having an affair, wouldn't you?
Hey, Luke's still not well.
Oh, Tony, you've been on the sides here reporting for duty.
Diane, I promise, I swear, I haven't been anywhere near him.
All those after-hours drinks you've had. Hey, all those shifts you covered for me when I've been in hospital with me sick daughter.
No, it's not Tony. It's someone I got close to. A shoulder to cry on. It was someone at the gym.
He's married with kids and it's over because he was hurting them just as much as I am destroying my family.
I am so sorry. You two are my closest friends and I owe you so much. You have to believe me.
Well, if I've jumped to the wrong conclusion, then I'm sorry.
Tell everything back to normal now after screaming at me till 4 in the morning.
Well, where are you going?
I'm off to sleep with all the women at the cash and carry, and then the deli, and then the butchers.
Paul Linguini, that's a good choice. That's a Tony special, although I think he's good at other things like sleeping with my missus. Turns out it's a guy from the gym. Bit of a cliche, though, don't you think? Gym guy, what do you reckon?
Excuse me, lady, sorry. I think I'll take the soda. Seriously, what is wrong with you?
I think I'll take this in my own private collection.
Put that back.
Make me.
I know you're going through a rough patch, but please don't start drinking again. I think he already has.
How about when you find out your partners are cheating, you come back to me with a bit of sympathy, eh?
You're just dropping your shift.
Well, if I can't drink it on the job, I might as well take it elsewhere, mightn't I?
Okay, you can't drink on the job because you don't have a job anymore.
You can't sack me from this place. Me and my wife are a third in on this. See you later, ladies.
What are we going to do about him?
Hey, what's the clothes sign up?
I haven't really been sleeping with everyone at the butcher's. There was only Big Ray serving.
We need to have a private meeting.
Andy, not about?
Well, she's not invited us, actually. And neither's Luke. We've decided to buy them out.
Oh, is this still about you being jealous of Mandy?
No. It's about Luke being a drunken liability.
He's drinking again.
He's a mess and he's not pulling his weight. Yeah, he comes and goes as he pleases and it's just one embarrassing cock-up after the next.
Yeah, come on, I'm not stabbing our friends in the back. They've got a young family to support.
Yeah, and we've got a poorly daughter to look after. Tony, we don't need any more stress.
Oh, sorry about that. I'll keep my head down for now on, I promise. Can't have the kids think I'm a layabout, can I? Is that what I said? I mean, Mandy, I haven't been on the ball, but we don't sell our shares in this place.
Look, we just don't think you've got the energy to put into this place right now.
I disagree.
Yeah, so do I.
Luke is one of us, all right? You know, he's having a tough time right now and, you know, we should be supporting him. Like you supported me when I messed up gambling. And then you had your painkiller addiction. I'm sorry, but it's true. And don't get me started on you two.
Yeah, all right, Darren, we get it.
We've all had relationship problems, right? And where would we be without second chances? And Luke deserves a break more than anyone I know. Well, doesn't he?
Of course you do.
Yeah, you do, Luke. We're with you, mate.
I promise you I'll do everything I can to make this place a success, yeah? I'll stop obsessing over who this guy is and what he's got that I haven't. Thank you.